Grand Rising loves, this is the altar spread for the collective today. And it's kind of eclectic, to be perfectly honest. It's all over the place, kind of how society is right now. My spread for myself is way more cohesive, but let's see if I can find the common undercurrent. So usually I don't even go into the undercurrent of it. I let it come through as I'm doing the reading for you. And so I choose the cards. I'm sipping my beautiful cup of love while I'm doing this. And then I just, so basically I'm giving you this reading on the fly. I choose the cards, but I'm not doing the reading until it's here. So it's real time. And you're getting that authentic voice of self, because as I teach, I don't think before I speak. I'm a conduit. And so when you do that, you become more spirit than human. So here I am offering myself to you at my altar. So Ka is the sacred geometry that showed up today. And look at that. I mean, this is beautiful rainbow Taurus. And it's interesting because Taurus has been the card that's been showing up for me, myself lately, and just my own personal pull. And that's not what showed up for me today. But it's interesting that Ka showed up for the collective. So Ka is a rainbow Taurus, but Ka is the part of the word Merkabah that talks about spirit, right? Because that's body, spirit, it's our parts. Ka is the part of us that's our authentic self, our true self, the soul. And so the Taurus is that which joins everything. It's the portal of connection to time, dimension, space, all that is, and source. And Ka is our life force. It's our energy. It's our spirit. And so this, the message of Ka, this particular card, is enlightenment, the path of ascension, spiritual path. And so the lotus flower actually represents that, the ascension towards that blossom, right? Because the actual lotus comes out of the earth. It's that rootedness. And so we can take great lessons from the lotus, that we are rooted here in the earth experience. And then each day it rises through the water, through the emotion, through that fluidity, to then open its blossom to not only the fresh air and be birthed anew each day, but to the light. And so think of the symbolism of that. Staying rooted each day can reach full ascension and open its petals to the light. And I love how there's a dragonfly hidden in this card too, because dragonfly is my totem. So I am always like looking at all of the minute details of everything that shows up. Also ascending numbers 5, 6, it's the number of ascension, just like 2, 3, 7, 8, whatever. Anyhow, Ka means you embodying your authentic self. Can you be that authentic self? Meaning that unapologetically, you are that without editing, and in every single environment, in any company, you are that. And so let your awareness go there today. What is your predisposition or propensity to? Is it to edit or not to? And so Pachamama talks about our connection to earth. So if you think about that lotus, you being the lotus, you must stay rooted in order to reach those great heights. If the lotus was not rooted, it would not have that nourishment in order to have that full blossom. If it was disconnected from the earth, it wouldn't have that ability to fully open. And so I feel the same way about our spirit, the soul, the energy body, that when we are not rooted, if you do not pay attention to the root chakra, then your energy becomes erratic and it's not as powerful, honestly. And that's when people become a little chaotic, unbalanced. So our connection to Pachamama, to Gaia, to Mother Earth is actually what helps balance that energy to reach the greater heights. That's the foundation. And just like if you want to build a skyscraper, you have to have that ironclad foundation. So really creating relationship with her by way of offerings and cultivating plants and getting your bare feet and palms in some dirt and soil and connecting to the elements that you are made of and that hold you. That's the message of Pachamama, to ground yourself. And so I believe that's the connection there between the Ka and the Pachamama cards, is that staying grounded so that you can reach the greater heights, because embodying spirit is the most important thing. And so calcite, spontaneity, talks about not spontaneity like let's do this on a whim, the spontaneity where you allow spirit to direct you. So really it's the same here, right? We're embodying spirit, just like myself when I do these readings, I'm allowing spirit to direct me. That's the real spontaneity. It's allowing the intuition to be your driving force, to propel you through any experience. And that's what true spontaneity is. True spontaneity is, even if it seems out of character, but you feel pulled to it, you do it, because obviously you're being guided by some higher force. And so this is calcite. This is optical calcite. And it really is a beautiful stone. If I can even capture some, it's got like amazing rainbows through it, but I don't know, because the windows are on this side, if you'll be able to even see it. Maybe not. Get the rainbows to show. How disappointing, because it really is beautiful. It doesn't look like much, right? It just looks like a block, but it's got these amazing rainbows in it. And really, that's how we embody our deepest beauty. It's not the surface, it's always much deeper. It's in I don't know if you can see that. I had it. It's in the much deeper fractioned self. So in the place where shadow meets our light, in those places where we have fractures in our spirit, those places where we've been injured or traumatized, and then we've allowed light to flow into those spaces, that's what makes us beautiful. That's what makes us unique. That's what you hear in the frequency of my voice. That's what you smell when my essence vaporizes off of my skin. That's what you feel when I allow my touch to graze you, or those who have been lucky enough to share breath with me in a kiss. That makes us beautiful. And so Ingonyama, honor of the ancient king, showed up, and I love this card, and I love the synchronicity of the 22 also. That's the harmonizing of relationship But Ingonyama talks about you entering a space and time now in which you will know what it feels like to be fully empowered, to be fully powerful. And I love the message of that, because we do deserve to be empowered. Fierceness does not come from cutting a bitch. Fierceness comes from love. It comes from that knowing, that original state of dignity where you are unapologetically you, because you are embodying the full frequency of love that you are. And knowing that no matter what, you are worthy of that same love that you embody. And if someone runs, they are not running from you, they run from love. If someone betrays you, they are not betraying you, they are betraying love. If someone injures you, they are not injuring you, they are injuring love. And it is their aversion to love that makes them react from that lowest surface level ego. And I've seen many people run. I've seen many people fight, squirm, be uncomfortable in my presence. And it's because I do that. And I will not allow myself to dim that level of love because it makes someone uncomfortable. And so that's me being empowered and fierce. So that's the spread for today. Being grounded and reaching those astronomical heights. And spirit is love, embodying love. Be spontaneous with it. Because when you open, when you allow the blossom to open, and it's like rebirthing yourself every day, you will be led on maybe new paths, new feels. I am constantly reinventing and rebirthing myself. That's true power. That's true power. That's the spread for today. Thank you. Someone told me today, this morning, when I speak, he says, when I hear your voice, I swear it's like God talking. Wow. I love you. I'm sorry. Please forgive me. Thank you. If only I could wait for you.